Adobe just launched a new AI feature, and I believe it will completely change the way we use Photoshop. So this new AI feature is called Generative Fill and is available natively in Photoshop. Just go to your Creative Cloud and download this new Photoshop, which is in beta right now. Okay, so let me show you how it works. So here's my photo before and after. Before and after, I removed some of these boats, I replaced the background here, I've added a few things like this cruise, for example, or this bungalow. And what's really amazing is that it creates those reflections automatically. It matches the perspective of your image and the style of your image, and even creates the shadows here, which is pretty amazing. So basically I went to Unsplash and I found this landscape photo, which is pretty good as a starting point, but I want to change a few things, right? So I'm just gonna copy this image over to Photoshop. So we're gonna do four things. We're gonna remove objects, we're gonna add objects, we're gonna change the background and expand the image. So first of all, I just wanna remove this thing here, which is, I don't know what it is, but it spoils the image because the water is so clear and nice. So I'm just gonna select this roughly and hit generative fill. I'm not gonna type in anything, I'm just gonna hit generate. Now you could argue I could do the same with content aware, but this works much, much better. It almost works flawlessly every single time. And as you can see here, creates a new layer, so it's not destructive. So you can always go back to your previous image. You have everything that is being generated on a new layer. So what I want to do is I also want to remove some of these boats because this is too much, because I want to put something else in there. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Now what I want to do is I want to add some objects here. I want here like a cruise ship right here. So I'm just going to select this area and I'm going to say cruise ship. I'm going to hit enter. I'm going to wait a few seconds and it's going to give me three options. Option number one, option number two, and option number three. All of them are amazing. It matches the perspective. It creates the reflections. I'm really happy with the first one. So let's move on. Now what I want to do is I want to create some bungalow here, right? Wow, that looks pretty cool. I think we're gonna go with this one. It kind of matches this boat. The size is good, the perspective is awesome, and the shadows are there. It's really amazing. Now what we want to do is I'm gonna quickly select the sky right here and I'm gonna say clouds. We have option number one, we have option number two, and option number three. I really like the second option, so let's leave it at that. I'm pretty happy with the results, so I'm just gonna group these. I'm gonna show you before and after. So we've cleaned up this thing, some of these boats, we've generated a few things, we replaced the background. I actually need this image in 16:9, not 3:2. So I'm gonna crop it like that. I wanna generate those sides right here because I need a bigger image, so I don't wanna cut this image. I just want to select these, hold shift to add selection on the other side, and I'm not gonna type anything. So basically when you do that, Photoshop automatically knows that you want to expand an image, and that looks amazing. We have the trees, we have these mountains. So here is before and after, before and after. So as you can see, this looks much, much more interesting. I can basically almost immediately use it for my project. So this new AI feature is pretty amazing, isn't it? And I'll be uploading more videos about AI features and AI tools for designers. So if you like this video, then consider subscribing to my channel, and I will see you in the next video.